This middle school is about me, Rafe Katchadorian, having a little trouble with authority, and also I'm really artistic, so those two kind of collide when this principal, Dwight, comes in and kind of destroys my artwork and like all my sketchbooks and all that that were like really sentimental to me. So I decide to destroy all his books, aka the rule books. My first encounter with Principal Dwight, I show up, just get ready, I'm ready to walk into school. I prepared for the day and everything, and then all of a sudden he stops me and he's like, "Hey, what are you doing? This is against dress code. Like, these are against the rules. You need to change." And it's not a very good first impression with the principal. Rafe decides to break every rule in the rule book by some sort of prank or setting something up. No unusual hair colors. He puts on like hair dye in the principal's hat to change his hair. Just a bunch of stuff like that to kind of ruin the rules in a fun way, but nothing that will put anyone in harm. Rob Riggle plays Bear. We were really excited. I was so excited to finally meet him in real person. He's a great guy. And Bear is sort of kind of the stepdad that no one likes. And he just kind of ruins our lives. He hates the dogs. He hates the kids, me and my sister Georgia. So he's not a nice guy in the script. Andrew Daly is the funniest guy. He is so funny. Him and Adam, when they improv, it's my favorite thing. I just like stay after set just to watch them improv. It's so funny. So Andy just really brings such a humorous new look on the character Principal Dwight. I always figured Principal Dwight was gonna be someone like really scary and someone really tough, and then Andy comes in and just brings such humor to the role, and I love it. Dwight is after those rules, like people following those rules so much because he wants to get perfect score on the blar, which gives him a huge bonus. And so he's really driven by all that just to get a raise. Alexa is the best. She's so funny in real life, so nice. She's the most mature 9-year-old I've ever met. And she kind of brings some of that little cuteness to the role and some fun kind of 9-year-old vibes to the role, but somehow like wiser beyond like her own years. I'm really looking forward to the animation sequence where it's my first day of school and I step out of line and I don't know what's going on. And there's a whole 360 transition from me into like the hallways, into this whole world of animation where things are just going crazy, like ants and all that kind of things. Vice Principal Ida Stricker turns into like a queen ant or something like that. I'm really looking forward to it. Jules is my mother, played by Lauren Graham, and she is a great person. She is trying to keep me on the right path, but she's not a strict parent. Rafe's relationship with Georgia is sort of like a brotherly, sisterly one because we're siblings, of course. And I always want to watch out for her. She's always got my back. We always work together to push Bear out of the house, even though we can never really succeed. But yeah, it's like we've got each other's backs and we never like tail on each other. We get into like little arguments, but never anything serious. We're always like a real brother and sister. I hope they actually take away some good memories from the movie because there are a lot of funny moments in this movie. So I hope they like take those away. And also on a more serious note, I hope they take like bullying isn't cool because I don't support bullying at all. So Miller the Killer, of course, like in the movie, Jacob plays a bully, but like none of us like bully each other in real life. Like we're all like really good friends, and I don't want like any of that going on. So I really hope they take away not to be mean to anyone, because forming friendships is better than forming enemies.
It's about Rafe Katchadorian. He's just, you know, a little shy, you know, not really the cool kid stereotype. So he's an artist, and he has his best friend named Leo. And they team up and they create this list of rules to break. And they try to break every single rule in the book before the end of the school year. My character, Jeannie Galetta, she's kind of, I guess, an overachiever. She cares a lot about academics, and she's the head of a lot of school clubs. And when Rafe causes kind of like an uprising and the principal gets mad, he decides to cancel all after school clubs. And she gets really mad about that. And Rafe sees that, so he is, I guess, inspired to break the rules even more and show Dwight, like, you can't mess with us. Principal Dwight, he's crazy. He cares a lot about the rules and maintaining just a very strict, conforming to society kind of lifestyle. And he tries to put that upon the kids at the school. And it's not really that great. He kind of over-exaggerates a lot. And he's just a funny guy. I mean, Andrew, who plays him, he's just the funniest guy. I'll see him improv-ing his lines, and it's just, I stay extra time on set just to see him do his scenes. He's a great actor. Jeannie sees that he's, like, a nice guy. I know in the book that she says that she works on him as a project, I guess. She wants to make him better. But I think in this movie, I like that Jeannie accepts the way he is, and in fact, she actually wants to help him. Griffin's a great guy. I've seen him work on his lines, you know, in his trailer. He leaves the door open, and he's really committed to, you know, making this just like a great role. And I think that he's just a really down-to-earth person, and he reminds me of my friends back at home. I think that's really important in this role, you know, for him to be relatable. Oh, Steve. He's a great director, and he's like an uncle to me, you know? They're all like family members to me. At first it was just like, hey, Steve, nice to meet you, very professional, but now we're just like joking around with each other. He's the great thing about directors is being able to express what you're thinking, I guess, and telling the actor what to do. He is great at doing that, because he used to direct music videos and stuff, so he knows how to explain the shots to actors and all of that, and he knows the pacing of things. So he'll tell me two beats until you do this, blah, blah, blah. And he's one of those directors that he can tell you one sentence and you'll know exactly what to do.
It's about this kid named Rafe Katchadorian, and, you know, he's having a hard time going through middle school with, like, bullies and girls and teachers, staff, and he's just not having a good time. So then, like, him and his friend Leo, which is me, are hanging out, and Leo suggests that they break every rule in the school handbook. Principal Dwight, like I said, he's not a nice person, and nobody really likes him. And I think the only one who can really stand up to that is Rafe. And I think he's not used to that. He spends a lot of his time doing drawing a sketchbook, because that's his passion, and I think that's how he expresses his creativity.
Middle school is about a boy named Rafe, who plays my brother. He's going through his middle school years, and he's just switching to this school because he had a couple issues with his past couple years of school. So it's about all the challenges that he faces and how he tries to get through his years of middle school. Georgia, she's a tough cookie, but she definitely has a sweet side, a very sweet and kind side to her, that you'll get to see both of her sides. And I think Georgia can mess with her family, but nobody else can. She's a force of nature, I think. We have so much fun. We're always laughing. We're always like telling jokes and stuff. And we're always playing with each other and stuff. He's really become like a big brother to me, which is nice because I'm an only child. So when I have someone like that, it's kind of cool. Middle school can be really tough fitting in, and I think it's the year where you start to realize that things don't always go as well as you think they should go, and it's sometimes really hard to fit in and make new friends at that age because you're starting to get older and some people can judge you a little more than they can in elementary school in those younger years. He is super fun. He's like so loving and I can learn so much from him and he teaches me so many things. He's so supportive and loving and he's super sweet and I really love working with him. I'm glad that he's my director. Rafe enjoys spending time with Leo because he can trust Leo and he can say anything to Leo without Leo judging him. Georgia is obsessed with driving. She'll drive anytime, anywhere. It can sometimes come in handy, but it can sometimes get her into a bit of trouble.
Hi, Vale here. I love animated movies and I got some awesome facts about Wreck-It Ralph. Now, there are almost too many video game Easter eggs to count in the movie, but one stands apart. Pay close attention to the Fix-It Felix arcade cabinet and you'll notice the high score of 120,501 or December the 5th, 1901, the birthday of Walt Disney himself. Who knew? Now, adding to that, for all the video game companies that gave rights to Disney for this retro adventure, the makers of the Mortal Kombat series weren't as willing. From the red eye, robot arm and tribal tattoos, fans may think they spot the classic character Kano in the Bad Unknown meeting, but he's actually credited as Cyborg for legal reasons, even though he still executes the fighter's signature finishing move, tearing the heart from a nearby zombie. What's your favorite animated movie? Let me know in the comments below and remember to subscribe to our channel for the best animated movie releases.